If you are an iPhone user, you know how precious your phone space is. And to manage this, most of the time we use iCloud or back it up in MacBook. But again, these options are costly. As for iCloud, you have to pay monthly subscription, and MacBook already have that space constraint. So I will left with an option to create a backup of our iPhone to an external hard drive. The answer is yes, but by default, you cannot choose where to save your backup. It will automatically get saved in your local drive. And I am going to simplify it so that you can create your phone's backup in an external hard drive. And also you won't require any special knowledge or any third-party application. The whole process is divided into three simple steps. So let's start this video with the first step, which is preparing your hard drive. And for that, first plug your external hard drive into your MacBook. Once connected, you will find your external hard disk folder on your desktop. Now create a folder named backup on your external hard drive. Remember, it is important to use capital B for backup. You can place this folder anywhere in your external hard drive. In my case, I have already created a folder named iPhone 14 Plus Backup, and under this folder, I have saved backup folder. Now we are done with the first step. Let's move into the next step, which is locating the backup folder on your MacBook. And for that, right click on the Finder and click on Go to Folder. Type library as you can see here, and then hit enter. This will open the library folder, which stores all the most important system file of your Mac. Now search for application support folder. Under application support, look for mobile sync folder. This is where your Mac saves all backup of your iPhone or iPad. Remember, if you have not synced your mobile with the Mac which you are using right now, you will not find this folder. So if you are able to find mobile sync folder, it's fine. If not, first you have to sync your mobile with the Mac which you are using right now. Now once you have located mobile sync folder, it's time to move to the next step, where we will move our existing backup and create the link between mobile sync folder and the backup folder which we have created in our external hard drive, so that from the next time whenever we sync our phone to Mac, the backup will directly get saved to the external hard drive instead of internal. Now let's start the last step by moving the existing backup to the external drive. And for that, copy the backup folder which is available under mobile sync folder and replace this folder with the backup folder which we have created under external drive. Once the backup folder is moved to external drive, delete the backup folder from mobile sync folder. And again, if you are unable to find backup folder under mobile sync, it means you do not have any backup in your Mac. And you can skip this step and directly jump into the last step, where we will link backup folder to the external hard drive with mobile sync folder on your Mac, so that your backup will saved on external hard drive and not to your MacBook. And for that, open terminal app in your Mac and type this command, lowercase ln space hyphen s space, then drag the backup folder that you just created on the external hard drive to the terminal. It will automatically capture the path of the folder. Next, go back to the application support and drag mobile sync folder into the terminal. This will create the path for the mobile sync folder. Now hit enter. As you can see, we just created the link between these two folders. Now to check whether the link is created successfully or not, go to the mobile sync folder. If you are able to find a backup folder which have a little arrow on it, it means you have successfully created the shortcut folder which will automatically redirect to your external hard drive where actually your backup is stored. Now you can do the backup of your iOS device and will automatically store on your external hard drive without taking space on your Mac. And with this setup, your future backup will automatically get saved to an external hard drive. If you have any question related to these steps, feel free to comment down below. I will respond you back. If you found this video helpful, please subscribe to my channel as I keep posting such tech-oriented videos. Thanks for watching. I will see you in my next video.